Hi, folks. Thank you for joining us for AmpFest so far. I hope you're excited about everything that you've been learning about what the AMP team has been up to for the past year. Now, I want to start off by thanking the team that's been working so hard to get this virtual conference together. My name is Naina Raisinghani, and I'm a product manager on the AMP project. My main focus is helping developers be more productive when they choose AMP. Now, it's 2020, but it's still a great time of uncertainty. And regardless of where you are, one thing remains constant, and that is the fact that investing in the web is critical to a business's success now more than ever. The web has been around for ages. However, even in 2020, developers are still finding web development difficult. And in fact, in late 2019, when Mozilla Developer Network conducted a survey to understand common web developer pain points, the issues spanned the entire development process, from writing code that was secure and accessible to browser interoperability. And helping developers address common web development pain points in a user-first manner is actually right there in AMP's vision and mission. So given all of this, what has the AMP team been up to in 2020? Well, we first unveiled our vision of AMP as a service on a spring morning in Tokyo at AMPConf 2019. And we talked about how engineering teams could accelerate their workflow by using AMP. So what has changed since then? And what does the future of AMP actually look like? That's what this talk is all about, in fact. AMP as a service is our focus on making AMP the easiest way for developers to create and then maintain high-quality web experiences without actually being burdened by issues such as performance or infrastructure. AMP's evergreen release schedule also means that these AMP experiences, once created, improve over time by becoming faster and more delightful without AMP developers having to invest any additional engineering resources. But what does this actually mean in reality? Well, when you build a website with AMP, you get a pit crew of engineers working behind the scenes to maintain your site's performance and improve your users' experience. And as the web evolves, so does your site. Which means that every week, your site gets an automatic tune-up that improves its actual performance, its accessibility, and it also offers you cool upgrades such as image optimization, modern JavaScript, etc. And all of this happens for free. And so what has AMP actually been doing to help out developers? Well, the first area that we have invested in is making sure that AMP pages do well on the metrics that are measured by Core Web Vitals and the upcoming Google Page Experience Ranking Signal. Now, the most obvious step we have taken is continuing investing in AMP's performance. This means that the AMP runtime and AMP's components are improving all the time. And some recent improvements you may have received are preloaded hero images and only serving modern JavaScript that your user's browser needs in order to serve the particular AMP page. Now, for those who are getting AMP visits on Origin, because they're investing in AMP first potentially, we have your back as well. Not only are these cache improvements available on the AMP optimizer, but the AMP optimizer is actually available in more places, such as 11t or Netlify. And if you want to learn more about the AMP optimizer, you can go to amp.dev/amp-optimizer. Now, like any other successful framework, we feel it's important to help developers debug AMP performance issues when they arise. And this is why we launched a diagnostic tool that helps developers debug why their AMP page may not be performing well on page experience. Now, this was a very quick summary, but if you want to learn more about this topic, you can actually listen to Ben speak about AMP and page experience. And speaking of performance, we also want to help developers make sure that their AMP pages are monetizing well. And this is why we released AMP Next Page, a component that helps publishers turn any AMP page into a continuous scrolling experience. It does so by loading additional recommended content from the publisher's website when the user reaches the end of a document. Now, this component was intended to help publishers increase engagement on AMP pages by actually increasing the time that the users spend on the site. And we're excited to share that this is already being used by publishers such as Forbes. Now, the screen grab you can see now on the screen is that of Forbes' live infinite scroll experience that's actually being powered by AMP Next Page. Now, we're also delighted to give advertisers and publishers more opportunities to monetize on AMP and have started working with Cargo to do just that. Cargo is a mobile-first advertising company that creates innovative campaigns for over 200 of the world's best-known brands. Now, we've started this relationship by actually adding support for Cargo Sidekick Unit, which you can actually see on the screen right now. Now, this partnership gives advertisers the ability to use Cargo's unique ad units on all of AMP's inventory. And this partnership is actually in response to requests from advertisers and publishers who actually wanted to increase media buying opportunities and creative ad executions on AMP. And speaking of units, let's actually talk about AMP components. Now, when a developer uses an AMP component, they're guaranteed that the components are written with users in mind. They're using components that are grounded in user research and that are tested for accessibility to make sure that all users are having a great experience. And to learn more about accessibility, you can actually watch Caroline's talk about accessibility in AMP. Now, one of the most onerous tasks in the software development cycle is actually maintaining infrastructure. A recurring request that we've received from developer teams has been to have an AMP release channel with longer intervals, which allows for a longer QA cycle. The long-term stable, or the LTS release channel, actually solves for this problem by only being released monthly. Now, we also received feedback that the 50 KB CSS limit that AMP enforced was way too small. And the intention of the CSS limit was to actually promote CSS hygiene, but we got feedback that the limit was still too tight. And so we worked with the AMP community to understand what a reasonable CSS limit could look like. And after working with plugin developers, news publishers, e-commerce site creators, etc., we realized that the most interactive experiences could actually fit in within 75 kilobytes of CSS. So that's what we made the new CSS limit. But we also want to provide developers with the tools to easily meet the CSS limit, and that's something that we've now started working on. But the optimizer can already help you here by doing things like removing white space. Now, using AMP also means that you get an infrastructure team for free, one whose job it is to make sure that your pages are actually performing well across all browsers with large market shares. Now, these are all just some immediate term improvements that the AMP team has made or is actually considering. And with that, thank you for joining me to learn about what our focus is in 2020 and beyond, the AMP as a service program. Our focus on making sure that AMP is the easiest way for developers to create and then maintain high quality web experiences. And now more than ever, we want developers to know that we really got their back. And that's why we're investing our time to make them more productive and make them more efficient. Now, this is just how the AMP team has been thinking about 2020. We have a lot more in store for you for 2021 and beyond. And to hear me speak about that, please watch the What's Next in AMP video. Now, let us know if you have any questions. I am NanaR92 on Twitter if you want to chat. And our GitHub project is always open to those looking to leave some feedback. With that, I hope you enjoy the rest of the content that we have prepared for you. Remember to stay safe, wear a mask, social distance, and wash your hands. Thank you.